and Transport has commissioned a 123 million suspension cable footbridge that will connect the districts of Kasese and Bunyangabo. Here's more.
The new cable bridge connects Kasese and Bunyangabo districts through Bwesumbu and Kabonero and was constructed across River Rwimi. Locals say before the bridge was constructed, crossing the river was a problem. Some residents met their death on this same bridge, especially while crossing during the rainy seasons.
See, tombed because of being drawn into water. And as earlier told you, that you can see now the weather changing. People could now not be here, would be now rushing. Because this river you see can change any time and you find it here. But because of this bridge, people will continue on with their businesses. And here we have the market. And we usually get people from this side. And they also have a market. So we shall now keep crossing.
Residents also say security in their area has improved. Before, it was hard for the army to cross to the other side of the bridge, while transporting produce to the markets was very difficult and costly. This has changed for the better.
Nusanga abano kubaka hende kabachali bana batu kunsiri abandi abana. Nusanga myani mwana myaka 17 mwana ahende kero mugongo.
The bridge was constructed by Bridge to Prosperity Organization as part of a memorandum of understanding with the Ministry of Works to construct bridges in hard-to-reach areas. According to Andrew Zirimenya, the project manager in the Ministry of Works, this is the third bridge to be completed under the agreement in Western Uganda. Chihumuro Suspension Cable Bridge that connects Kagadi and Chikube districts and Chabayenze Suspended Cable Bridge in Karambi Sub-County in Kasese District have also been completed.
Three more sites along Mabuku River, other sites on a certain river called Iruboni. But because of the limitations of the span we have currently, we have found some sites like along River Nyamwamba very difficult. But we are discussing the NGO to revise the design by either providing for slightly longer spans and wider decks. So that discussion is going on. Then we shall be capable of undertaking probably spans up to 150 meters. But by far, the designs we are undertaking, they are limited to 120 meters across the river. So the needs assessment is continuous, and we do it jointly with the district local government. They do the identification, then they call us to do that preliminary technical and social survey. And then we submit to the next level. And then the final approval is done by the top leadership of the Minister of Works and Transport for the site.
Zirimenya says there are plans of increasing such projects across the country
annually. But now we are scaling up the targets to 6. Then the next financial we shall do 8 bridges. So you see we are scaling up. As we roll out, we keep on scaling up the targets because the needs are growing. They are growing, and we have a lot of sites that have been surveyed, and we have found them to be technically feasible, so we have to scale up the targets.
John Charlie Gonza, the LC3 chairperson of Kabonero Sub-County in Bunyangabo District, praised the Ministry of Works for the initiative. He challenged the districts to develop the road network so locals can easily transport their produce to the markets after crossing the bridge.
And now I'm asking the community to ensure that they utilize this opportunity, this bridge, so they have to work hard in order to produce goods. This bridge is not just for watching, but it should be having a purpose of bringing services delivery through farming and animal keeping.
Report by John Antusingwire for the news.